Oh, belum. Oke.
Oke, sudah boleh nampak lah.
Ya, Pak. Hari keluar ke sini.
Boleh nampak.
How do you remove this? Tuh. Bila teknikaliti ni tak berapa pandai jadi macam ni. What do you understand about nuisance so far?
Ganggu.
Kacau ganggu eh. So, have you ever experienced kacau ganggu? What is kacau ganggu in the first place? Sebelum kita tengok what situation that you have suffered, yes.
Noises and pollution or whatever.
Yeah. Pollution, right? Yes. So that is considered as something that is related to our daily life lah. Somebody has done something that that it affects our, what you call it, enjoyment, yeah. So either in a public punya domain ataupun a private domain. What do you mean by public public domain and private? Private, if you're talking about your own position, your own rights, yeah. Kalau when it comes to public, it's about your rights as a citizen, okay. Private, your right as a person who owns that particular piece of land. So you are the kacau ganggu. You are, you know, you are being nuisance by somebody. Yeah. So you are not happy. You are not able to enjoy your land. Kalau public, you as a citizen of Malaysia would not be able to enjoy. Yeah. Your freedom as a citizen. So kalau you want to relate nuisance, law of thoughts of nuisance with respect to federal constitution, and then right of life, right of life, that is the article, yeah, under federal constitution, that anak kepada federal constitution of the article is nuisance, yeah, in order for the citizens to be protected. You need to live, right? In order, live means you need to live happily. Okay. So if somebody is coming and kacau you, and you are not able to enjoy your life, then you have avenues for you to take. It is also a criminal. Yeah. Kalau you tengok dalam penal code, there is a prohibition in terms of nuisance. Okay. So the government, the Attorney General can take action against you. Under, say for example, we have environmental law. Yeah, so that is in a way nuisance to the enjoyment of the society, of the, you know, the well-being, yeah, or the happiness from our environment. So we know one thing that is obvious is the impact in terms of our supply of water, right? So the state through the agencies that they have with the federal government have the power under article what do you call it, under the federal constitution, the concurrent list, in order for them to take action against those people who interfere with somebody else's enjoyment or right to life. Yeah. Okay. So we are coming down to nuisance per se in terms of law of thoughts. So dekat sini, I make a note. Okay. You know very much or very well until now that law is about duties and rights. Whenever you talk about law, law is about duty. Yeah, it's also about rights. So whenever people mention about law, you know it is about duties and rights. It's a combination of that. You cannot have duties without rights. You cannot have rights without duties. Okay, you kena ada hak dan tanggungjawab. So kalau hak dan tanggungjawab it is combination, kita akan nampak that is law. Kalau just duty saja, then it's not fair. Yeah, it is not fair for you to owe a duty to the societies or to the nation, tapi you tak ada rights. So being a Malaysian, you have rights and duties. So the same thing with law of nuisance. Yeah, since you owe that, what you call it, rights, you have that rights, you also owe a duty towards others. So you have every rights to enjoy your land as much as you like. Hey, nak buat apa, lantak lah, yeah, it's up to you. But at the same time, your rights tak boleh go towards somebody else punya rights, yeah, and that is your duty. Your duty is to make sure that other people can enjoy their what they call it, their land, their right to existence. So law of nuisance is one branch of law of thought, which is the purpose is to provide comfort to the person who is the property interest in land. So if you have the interest in your land, then therefore you are able to have that what they call it, rights, yeah, and nobody can encroach into your rights. To members of the society generally through control of environment conditions, yeah. So nature, in terms of you ada your what they call it, your senses, yeah. Our senses is smell, hearing, you know, taste and sight, yeah. So if you are being encroached in that senses, yeah, or your senses, then therefore you have every right to take action against somebody else because the environment is changed. Although a person who have interest in land is able to do whatever he or her wishes on their land, their activities, however, must not cause inconvenience or damage to another person who are similarly have their interest over their land. So, you punya hak, you can enjoy your land. Yeah? Kalau you nak pasang lagu, you have every rights to do so. Yeah, especially kalau you duduk dekat apartment like myself. Yeah? You obviously have to do things in order for you to enjoy your apartment, such as nak drill, such as renovation, such as vacuuming, which is normal lah for any household to do that. Nak enjoy in terms of pasang lagu, as I mentioned just now kan, you have every rights to do that. Can your neighbor, next neighbor who doesn't like that kind of songs that you play, you know, your songs definitely will cross the wall to another person. So can that person say that, oh, tak boleh lah, I don't like this. I had a neighbor sebelah, dia, tapi dah pindah lah. Very good guy, tapi dia as an Indian, dia ada satu bilik tu memang dia buat untuk apa kata, semayang. Yeah. So kalau dia bakar or bunyi loceng, you know, things like this, dia buat dia punya prayers, so it is considered as nuisance lah. Tapi I cannot bring out that nuisance punya claim, legal nuisance, so I cannot put it there saying that, hey, you are interfering with my enjoyment of my space, right, by, you know, bau, by the, what they call it, bunyi and things like that. So it's not fair, yeah, for me to do that. So why? Because I'm living in an apartment, everyone have their own right, and the space, even though, ambil contoh lah, kira macam you duduk dekat dalam bas, yang sempit, so your domain, your personal space akan jadi kecil, yeah, your personal space akan jadi kecil, so therefore you cannot complain much. As compared to you duduk dekat what they call it, bungalow, yeah. So bungalow's situation is different. Kalau lah excessive that particular neighbor of yours pasang lagu or buat activities that encroach into your area, that might be considered as nuisance. The same thing, different places, different environment can fall into nuisance. So it depends. Yeah. So the law of nuisance is mainly concerned about to balance the competing interests of people. So everyone wants to have their own way of enjoying their land, and the law must make sure that this so-called interest is proportionate. So you can do whatever you want on your land, but they must have the but. So nampak tak? You have the right to enjoy, meaning right, and but you are not to encroach into somebody else, you know, enjoyment of their land, which is your duty. So it is a combination of right and duties. So Alan, remember guys, you can always you know, ask questions, stop me, you know. So any questions that you want to ask?
Not at the moment, sir.
Tak ada, eh? Okay, how do we look at the nuisance, eh? Because kita nak kena identify nuisance as to compare nuisance with other kind of thoughts. There are similarities, yeah, when it comes to nuisance compared to other law of thoughts. For example, nuisance dengan trespass to land, you know. So nuisance is common with negligence and strict liability. Strict liability is, you, I think kita tak belajar lagi kan. So strict liability is just similar to negligence lah. Tapi formula dia cepat, eh? Formula dia a very fast way of us to get a compensation as compared to negligence. Negligence dia lambat. Yeah. So strict liability, negligence, you know, they are similar things that we want to compare and contrast. Yeah. Trespass to land, you know. Kita dah buat last semester trespass to land kan? So how do you compare nuisance and trespass to land? So only a direct act may give rise to action of trespass to land. Direct act meaning you are doing it on purpose, yeah, encroaching into somebody else land with the intention, yeah. So direct means there must be mental, yeah. So you, the defendant, sorry, the plaintiff must be able to provide evidence to the court that the defendant had voluntarily enter into that somebody else land, you know, and it is considered as a direct act. So you move your feet into somebody else land, so that is considered as direct act. However, nuisance is about consequential harm. Yeah, so you don't have to be inside somebody else land, but the action that you do, yeah, for example, just now I kata pasal lagu kuat kan, so that is harming somebody else. Eh? Consequence of your event that you do in your particular land, right, impact somebody else right to enjoy. So that is harming somebody else and right to enjoy by doing something on your space. Yeah. So macam my neighbor, which I bagi example tadi kan, dia nak semayang and things like that, bau kemian, bau, you know, kalau you have Chinese neighbors and things like that, things that they want to enjoy in terms of religious practices. So that one you rasa macam mengganggu, you know, tapi you tolerate because you are living in that situation. Yeah. So kalau you tak nak, then you pergi duduk dekat rumah banglo lah, ataupun situation or places where the population is very minimal. So you don't have to face this kind of things. Okay, so this can be seen in the case of government of Malaysia and another against and Akasha bin Ahad. Yeah? So this one petrol station, if I'm not mistaken, I don't know whether you're familiar or not. If I'm not mistaken, because my facts might be wrong, but I think 10 years ago, I did some research about this particular case. It is about the petrol station, eh, yang ada dekat tepi highway, dekat Dengkil, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. Kalau ia pergi daripada Shah Alam ke Dengkil, dulu kalau nak ikutkan 30 years ago when we had practices of palapis, rotu over there dekat Dengkil, it was still a black area, I think 30 years ago. So dekat jalan Dengkil ni daripada Shah Alam, so dia akan pergi kat satu simpang, dia ada satu simpang, satu ke IOI Mall, satu ke Dengkil, satu daripada Shah Alam. So dekat situ ada satu petrol station. Kalau sekarang, kalau you lalu, dia dia dekat corner yang nak pergi ke Putrajaya tu, daripada IOI, kan ada viaduct and things like that. So kalau you corner yang bawah tu, you akan nampak sebelah kiri petrol station yang dah ditutup. You know, that is the consequence of the highway. People have a problem accessing, and then dia jadi macam macam landlock lah, because orang nak masuk highway itu, dia nak corner, dia corner tu rapat and then nak masuk. So it is going to be a very inconvenience for people, and then apa, you know, business is not good lah. So the government propose to buat jalan special, jalan yang you actually jalan yang ke Dengkil tu sebenarnya yang ada tractors apa semua. Perasan tak kalau you lalu kat situ ada nampak apa company tractors on your left kalau you dah heading towards Putrajaya. Dulu jalan tu semua tak ada, that particular road dah memang tak ada. Jalan yang ada sebenarnya jalan yang dekat masjid tu, masjid yang dekat Masjid Dengkil, dia jalan kecil je sekarang, ya, yeah? Jalan kecil itu jalan lama. So so the government wants to propose to do that jalan, dia tak nak. Okay. So what happened, dia sue, right? And then obviously the court found that the plaintiff had failed to prove nuisance, yeah, because what do you mean by nuisance? It is based on between trespass to land dengan if you compare trespass to land dengan nuisance, dia lain, eh, in terms of the harm that you you create towards somebody else. Dia kata kat sini, whether the act is a nuisance or trespass depends on whether a person is in direct physical interference. So kalau direct physical interference, the government did not go to the extent of entering into the land, yeah, of another person. So dia ada hak untuk nak buat dia punya highway, but the consequence of that, yeah, here we are talking about the consequence of that. Here trespass means a direct act as compared to nuisance, which is the interference of the plaintiff interest over that particular piece of land. Okay, so obviously it does not necessary for the defendant to be entering into the plaintiff land. Okay, kita tengok any questions so far. Which one, trespass to land, nuisance, offer severe damage penalty? So it depends. Kalau you as a lawyer later on, you semua taruh. You saman orang, kalau if you are the lawyer, you jangan simpan, eh. So if you want to claim, you claim semua. Okay, macam you nak baling batu dekat orang, baling banyak batu. So kalau salah satu batu tu kena, okay lah, at least you menang. Kalau you baling satu batu je, chances of that batu untuk probability, ya, yeah, in terms of that batu nak kena tu very low as compared to you baling machine gun. Okay, it's a good example, machine gun. Yeah, one kata machine gun is a tembak, eh, you tembak semua. Kalau kena, kena. So it is a more practical way of doing things. Sana, macam mana dia keluar ni? Kacau lah benda ni. What is happening? Nak remove it. Nak pindah ke kiri, tak boleh. Hey. Cik sangat. Okay, tak apalah. So nampak eh, kalau nuisance dengan negligent, it is overlap. Yeah, here I put a note here. Though overlap and link does not need to be. Yeah, meaning they are not together. You can sue someone, you as the lawyer for your client, right? You can sue on your on behalf of your client, negligent and nuisance and what they call it, trespass. So but you just cannot claim everything without justifying. So you have to justify lah. So you can do whatever you want. It's up to the defending lawyer untuk you know, counter your claim. So menang, kalau menang, kalau betul lah, say for example you claim towards somebody else nuisance dengan negligent, the court akan bagi satu je, okay, to compensate you back to the position of, because law of tort is to not pay more than you deserve. It is just giving what you suffered in order to compensate you seconds to your accident that you suffered. So kalau nuisance, dia akan bagi compensation that you know, you are able to enjoy balik, yeah, ataupun the damages that you suffered, katalah tilang tu sampai to the extent buat you sakit, and then the medical cost of your sakit to repair you back to normal is amounting to 100,000, and they have to pay that 100,000. And then on top of that, you jangan pula claim untuk tu saja, you claim lah untuk yang benda-benda lain, like apa yang you dah belajar, kita minta injunction. So that is one of the remedies yang you minta on top of the damages. So remember guys, you claim banyak costs, you know, at the same time you claim all the possibilities of damages in terms of the number of damages that they are. So you apply, yeah, that's two area. One is about all the thoughts that is relevant that you think that might be able to apply in your particular problem. And the second thing is about not forgetting what type of damages that you want to claim. So all damages that is relevant for you to put in as your under the statement of claim, then please do so, yeah. Soalan. So kalau kita tengok nuisance and negligence, dia ada certain overlap lah kalau kita tengok sini, ya. However, it does not go to the extent that you must prove what they call it, negligence together with nuisance. Ni kita tengok the case of, dia kata statement ni, macam dia kata, does not mean that negligence is a prerequisite in action for nuisance. So you don't have to prove that there is negligence. It can come on its own. Nuisance can come on its own. For example, kalau kita tengok Wisma Punca Emas, Sdn Bhd. So this one, plaintiff clinic was, he claims that he suffered, yeah, in terms of excavation or piling works that is being done by the Wisma Punca Emas Sdn Bhd, the construction that was being done. So sampai to the extent that the plaintiff wall and crack and tilted. So the defendant held that, defendant held lah. The defendant contended that he has taken all reasonable steps. Yeah. So under negligence, remember last time, so you owe a duty. How do you know that you owe a duty? So the person must be proximate, and you have to foresee. So foresee means you have taken all reasonable steps in order for you to avoid that damages. So the court allowed plaintiff claim and granted his damages. The defendant tak puas hati, so they appeal, and then when it went up to the Supreme Court, the negligence is not the requirement of nuisance, yeah? So because claim tu is based on nuisance, so the argument that the defendant wants to put across that they are together, okay? So if you want to claim for nuisance, you have to prove negligence first. So the court says they are not together, okay? They can be together, right? It is a means for a person to claim, sebab remember that thoughts, you can only claim certain amount, yeah, tak boleh dapat banyak kan. So kalau you minta and thoughts of negligence and nuisance. So if the court says, oh, other nuisance and other negligence and nuisance, dia akan bagi satu saja the remedy. Yeah, the remedy is going to be only one, because the cost of your damages is what. So that is the amount that is going to be given, even though you mungkin ada trespass to land plus negligence plus nuisance. Tak kira eh. Kalau dia tiga-tiga dapat proof pun, still compensation is going to be only one. So they try to do that, try to macam technicality lah, it goes to appeal because they nak menang on technicality based on facts. Memang the suffering of the clinic towards the war that they have is clear. Yeah, itu memang dah clear. It's just a matter of they want to run away from technicalities, trying to say that, oh, you have to read together with negligence which was not proven, so therefore my appeal should be granted in terms of rejection of the plaintiffnya claim lah. So tak ada. So the court kata there is nothing there. So court dia kata, cakap sini dia kata the such cause of action in this case was founded on natural right of support. Yeah. So the claim, pandai juga lawyer dia. Dia kata natural right of support. Dia tak argue in terms of nuisance per se. Yeah, because nuisance ni dia very subjective. Dia tak ada clear test. Okay. Kalau sekali lagi kita tengok kat bawah tu, when every law yang kita belajar in terms of thoughts, dia mesti ada judicial, macam mana kita bagi, dia ada binding judicial precedent. Binding judicial precedent mesti ada daya pengikat. Daya pengikat untuk law of thoughts is test. Okay, so every course akan pakai the same test. Okay, depending on which one is the best test made by superior courts, right? So as I mentioned, this test dekat nuisance dia kurang sikit. Yeah, ada requirement dia, tapi nanti you realize that it's not going to be, you know, so clear like trespass to person, yeah, assault, ada tiga, you know, things like that. So this one ada juga, tapi the interpretation of the courts towards the argument of nuisance, you as lawyers nanti, you have a tough job lah in order for you to prove. So your understanding untuk ni is important lah, because kalau you nak practice nanti later on. So nuisance dengan Ryland Fletcher, remember you tak introduce lagi kan? Ryland Fletcher is whereby you bring something that is inside your land which is not natural, and that particular nature that you bring in. Yes, anyone?
Tak. It's about racun serangga ke apa benda gitu kan?
Ryland Fletcher. Siapa yang tahu dia punya facts?
Dia apa sembuh kat dia punya plant tu apa benda something, lepas tu hujan and then dia pergi ke sebelah ke something like that. Tak boleh ingat.
I think Ryland Fletcher is the ada apa? Dia buat tahan air. So dia buat tahanan air. So nak kata dam, tak ada air, it's a mini dam, reservoir. And then what happened is dia collect air, then benda tu pecah. Okay, pecah and then went into the neighbor punya, what they call it, dia ada mining shaft, so banjir lah masuk ke dalam tu. Jadi si Ivan Omsaker lah, dia lupa dah Ryland Fletcher, Ivan Omsaker.
Lepas tu ada tulis toxic ke apa benda dekat dia punya tu, lepas toxic tu orang sebelah tu
toxic apa dia reservoir. So betul lah. Okay, coal shaft. it was a position that it was flooded. So jadi kalau you tengok kat sini, kalau Ryland and Fletcher is about every something that you have done in your space. Say for example, you blur ular, you know, you have every rights to enjoy your space. Ular tu terlepas, ya, pergi ke rumah orang lain, and you know, have created mischief lah, ataupun create problems, ya. Dia patuk orang lain ke, dia oh, okay. Ada that lady, ya, dia rasa tidur tu dia rasa macam sedap bila dekat leher dia. Dia tengok ular, tapi dalam keadaan tu ular dia yang nak belit dia. So somebody else punya ular sawa yang dia bela, boleh, ya, to the extent you know, come in and kill you, alright, so bite you or things like that. So jadi kita nak compare macam mana? Here you're talking, nampak ada similarity dekat situ, but it does not mean that you have to prove there is Ryland and Fletcher punya rule in order for nuisance to take place. So nuisance can be in a position that apa kata, standing on its own, yeah. So that is Ryland and Fletcher. So kalau dekat kita nak compare lagi, Ryland Fletcher ni is a single act, whereas as compared to nuisance is a continuous act. Say for example, pasang lagu, you know, for example pasang apa kemian, you know, for example apa lagi, ya, too many things lah, ya, that encroach into somebody else punya rights to enjoy their land. But Ryland and Fletcher, dia cuma ataupun you have to apa orang kata, single act dia dah cukup, ya, yeah. Tapi kalau nuisance dia nak macam berterusan in order for you to say that you suffer, okay. For example, orang nak main renovate rumah you, right, the contractor akan buat something to your premise to your land. Dia nak campaign hacking, that can drilling. So those kind of activities is just one off, okay. So dia katalah you nak kata dalam nuisance dia mesti continuous in nature, maksudnya benda tu tiap hari dia buat, okay, tiap hari for the rest for 6 months ataupun for a year, you know, that give rise to the rights to sue under nuisance. Okay, kalau one off aja, it's about one day punya renovation or 1 week punya renovation, then it's considered as reasonable, yeah. So kalau reasonable, kalau lah setahun asyik duk renovate, yeah, then that might be nuisance, yeah. Soalan?
So, yang tadi tu yang continuous tu bermakna nuisance ke yang continuous tu Ryan and Fletcher?
Nuisance dia.
Ryan and Fletcher tu macam a special use of that land, so it's continuous macam pasal mining tu. So dia macam sentiasa dia continuously a nuisance yang continuous ni mengacau kita lah. So it consider as Ryan and Fletcher, betul ke? Ataupun
macam mana? Ataupun Jamie?
Ataupun just yang once is a nuisance kalau sesekali dibuat, tapi kalau yang continuous is a Ryan and Fletcher.
Okay, the other way around, where we are talking about nuisance is continuous rather than Ryland is one off. One off macam mana tu? Dia keep that animal, for example tadi apa lagi, snake tu. Snake tu ada dalam rumah dia, irrespective whether dia boleh ke, simpan ke tak, that is another issue lah. But dia escape, you know, or the thing escape. Bila dia escape, it takes only one time, yeah, that you can prove that the snake enters into your land, therefore you take action against the owner. So under the rule of Ryland and Fletcher, there are a few requirements lah. So benda tu dangerous and then it escape and then you suffer damages, ada tiga element, very straightforward as compared. Dia nampak exactly dia negligent, tapi faster way, a speedy way of you to win your case rather than you choose negligence. Negligence, you know lah, last semester kan, it is very technical and very long process. So Jamie, to make it short, Ryland and Fletcher is about one off. So if it happens again, then you have another course of action. So you have another damages that you can claim. As compared to nuisance, it's about a continuous. You have to go to the court and say that there is a continuous thing that is happening that encroach into my rights to enjoy my land. So if you are the lawyer, you must prove that. If you are using nuisance, you must prove to the court that the interference is prolonged in terms of anyone in that position cannot tahan. You in that position tak boleh tahan. Bau tu continuous for 3 months. How are you to live? Kalau dia apa kata sambut perayaan pasang kemian for 3 months, you know, that is not reasonable. So nanti kita belajar the element of reasonableness of the action of the defendant. Boleh, Jamie?
Okay, boleh. Faham. Thanks.
Sorry. Jangan sorry, guys. I don't like the word sorry.
Okay. So tadi yang Ryland Fletcher tadi, Sir mention element dia is dia kena one off, and then dia specific case and ada involve danger.
Danger meaning what type of danger? You dekat rumah, you ada tong gas, right? You ada tong gas. So is it reasonable for you to simpan for the contingency of COVID 10 tong gas dalam rumah as reserve? That is considered as something that is dangerous. You bring in, and you know that it is dangerous, and you put into your house and it explode. Yeah. So the explosion is considered as Ryland and Fletcher. Something dangerous that you put into your premise and it escape and causing damages to others.
Okay. Ryland Fletcher ni kira liability lah sebab macam.
Dia strict. Dia meaning dia tak ada tanya-tanya lagi. Macam negligent dia akan tanya, oh, you owe a duty in order to show proximity and forcibility, and then standard, you whether you breach that standard or not, whether you are the cause of the damages, you know, the three tests of negligent. The violence is very straightforward, very simple. Yeah. So kalau you as lawyers nanti, you're talking about suing someone, hentam, you claim Ryland, you claim trespass, you claim negligence. So macam Wan kata tadi lah, tembak je lah. Boleh?
Okay.
Allah, ada orang nak masuk, sorry.
Okay, boleh.
Okay, so damages and remedies macam mana pula? Yeah. Harm or damages that usually occurs in nuisance cases are two types, yeah, namely damage, number one, okay, and then second is personal comfort. So you rasa tak selesa, you tak boleh tidur, orang dah buat renovation pukul, you know, 24 hours, you know, malam pun nak buat renovation, it is not reasonable lah. Okay, so damages that you suffer might not in physical. Kadang-kadang kalau kita tengok kilang yang ada chemical that they malam dia lepas asap tu, so you are choked, yeah? So you tak boleh nak nafas. So that is in terms of damages that you suffer, ataupun rosak habis you punya perabot, yeah? because of debu and things like that. So that is considered as damages to the property, yeah. Personal comfort, and then you nak tidur pun tak boleh, you know. So macam mana you nak prove? So that is an issue, kan? Macam mana you nak kata you suffer in terms of tak boleh nak tidur? So itu subjective elements yang I kata the court will take into consideration based on fact, case to case punya basis, you know. The court have avenues to say whether your personal comfort is being being tarnished by the activity of your neighbor. Okay, so that is two. Yeah? However, it includes nuisance by encroachment of another's land, yeah, on a neighbor's land. In both instances, the measure of damages is the diminution of value of the land. So if you're talking about property loss, yeah, in terms of the value of your land, orang ni kalau nak jual pun dah tak boleh dah, because the activity that is done by your neighbor, meaning somewhere kalau kita kilang dengan baru dibuka dekat situ, so that particular kilang telah menjatuhkan you punya value, that is the argument or damages that you want to proof to the court in terms of the you buat orang panggil valuation, yeah. So you do the valuation of your land, and then it was discovered that initially before the factory was erected, the value is higher as compared to now, because nobody wants to stay next door to kilang, eh? You know, kilang, they don't care about other people. They can do according to the law, but still the activities, law ni cuma bagi minimum requirement of you as a kilang to do, eh? Yeah, kalau you ada, kena ada environmental punya activities that you have to, macam catalytic converter of the asap and things like that from the kilang. So that is something very minimal. So still the value of your land is going to diminish. Okay, so that is one. And then pure economic loss, yeah, in the form of the fall of value of the land had been held to be recoverable juga. Yeah, pure economic loss, you know, case apa? Still remember?
Apa je?
Pure economic loss. Still remember the case? Last time? Pure economic loss boleh claim tak?
Tak boleh, tak boleh.
Careful.
Pure economic loss yang kita tak nampak, tak boleh claim. Yang kita nampak yang boleh nampak. Claim.
Yang kita meaning for the rest of the group, kalau kita meaning the court yang boleh nampak, eh, based on the impact that can cause. If you can be lost, say for example, the electricity to the factory was disrupted. Eh? Ada case, eh? Nanti
tenaga yang dia buat excavate, yeah, to cable.
Cable, right? So what happened is that you can claim all the actual loss, meaning the actual thing that you suffered, right? Your production stopped, and then because of that, the material goes devalue. So the devalue amount is one of your claim that you can make. Secondly, you can also claim for the whole day for the whole week that the power is down. Okay, for the whole week, that is second. The first one is actual. Second is the future loss that you might suffer, because that is clear, it is foreseeable. And then the third one, kalau you nak claim for the inability for you to produce a certain product, yeah, in the future because you have lost a contract because of the electricity is not there. So you might have lost the ability to sign a contract with someone. That is pure economic loss. It's purely economic. That is not able for you to claim. So here, you're talking about pure economic loss that you can prove because of the nuisance being done by your neighbor. Then obviously you can take action against that person. Okay. Another remedy that you can claim for nuisance is the injunction. Obviously, selalunya majority of the claim of nuisance is about injunction. We want it to be stopped. Okay, so you want to have a peace of mind. You want to sleep. Therefore, you want that activity to be stopped. Okay? So you ask the court to issue injunction order, and for the person to actively do that. Pacific Engineering and Haji Ahmad Rice, therefore this one dia minta claim of damages plus the injunction, ya. Yeah. Ahmad Rais ni tahulah kilang gula, kilang gula pula. Macam saya kilang gula memang depan, ya. Yeah. So kami sentiasa ada bau gula yang tengah di dimasak gula tu kan. So memang kuat lah. Tapi nak buat macam mana, kan? So dari kita pun feeling uncomfortable, tapi di hilang dah lama, ya. Yeah. So dalam keadaan ni Haji Ahmad Rais dia memang dia akan buat proses, and then you know lah hampas padi tu. So it will, kalau dia bakar, you know, proses that they do akan menyebabkan so many surrounding area penuh dengan what you call it, hampas-hampas padi, ya. My wife dulu duduk dekat polis, and the whole family, if I'm not mistaken, the children lah, ya, yeah, suffered the eczema, ya, yeah, eczema because of the, you know, particles, ya, yeah, of padi yang dia, bukan padi, sorry, but it's not padi, it's the tebu, ladang tebu kan, bila dia nak replant, so they have to burn, ya, yeah. So burning itself, dia ada debu tu, dia menyebabkan the whole family suffered. Okay, sini saya tulis public nuisance, ya. A person of the group may affected by the activity conducted by another person must lodge their report, yeah, to the authorities in terms of health officer, local authority, ataupun make a complaint to the government in order for the government to take action under public nuisance. So here I mentioned about public nuisance is something that you want to take action against someone else under the remedies and damages, yeah. So kalau if you fight with a kilang who have millions under their belt, under their pocket, so it's going to be very difficult for you to win if you take action against that company under private nuisance. So rather than doing that, then you ask the government to be the one that is on your defense or on your attacking mode. So you want the government to be the one that is attacking the defendant. So you ask the government to take that particular case. And but you must be not only you must be many, yeah, two or more, in order for you to do that. We'll go that later on. So damages must be proven, yeah. So damages must be of those under reasonable foreseeable, yeah. So it is must be definitely under the law of negligence. Remember the third limb, the third test, the test of damages, whether it is being caused by the defendant act. So the same thing here, you must be able to prove to the court that the action of the defendant is the one that caused damages to you. Eh? What means by damages? It is reasonably foreseeable. Reasonably foreseeable, tak nak? Macam mana? Masih ingat, Tok Suan? Ada remoteness, remember remoteness?
Not too remote. The damage is not too remote. Yes.
The damage is not too remote. Damage must be something that is foreseeable. Yeah. What do you mean by foreseeable? By standard of reasonable man. Nampak dia kata reasonable foreseeable, meaning it must be from the standpoint of a reasonable person.
Sir, kalau damage tu penyakit ke? Tak semua orang tahu that it will cause that kind of sickness. Would it be considered as foreseeable damage?
Dia akan tunjuk sama ada the defendant new or should reasonably new that particular activity yang dia buat akan mendatangkan bahaya untuk orang lain. You know?
So kalau dia tak tahu, but then it already affected the plaintiff tu, so tak boleh claim apa-apa ke?
Then itu yang kita saman dia on negligent. Dalam negligent, even though kita ingat tak case of Bolam? Okay, ingat tak case Bolam?
Yang ingat, dia ada Bolam test.
Ada Bolam test kan? So Bolam test is no longer reasonably applied. Dia ada informed consent kan sekarang? So the same thing applies lah untuk the court. Even though something that you can share, the defendant can say, apa pula, tak ada benda pun, saya pun tak pernah tahu. No, if a person in your position, yeah, in the defendant's position, should the person nampak, you know, any pengilang yang lain yang duduk dalam keadaan you, kalau the plaintiff boleh cari satu pengilang yang tunjuk kata evidence that they realize about the impact, and this particular kilang that is the one yang buat ni, tak nampak, you know, semua orang boleh kata tak nampak kan. Tapi what you need to do is to prove that other kilang doing the same activities are aware of it. Habis, you know, the standard is being applied to that particular defendant, yeah, the one in question. So itu je kita main technicality, yeah. In order for you to win your case, insyaAllah, is to be able to use your brain banyak. Technicality, you have to anticipate apa yang dia punya argument, apa yang dia punya defend, what needs to be done in order for you to prepare your case, in order for you to have an airtight case to win. Yeah. So obviously semua orang nak win, tapi it is all about in technicality. It's not about the truth, but the truth kadang-kadang tak dapat pun.
That means masa kita nak charge here tu is the cause of action is based on negligence lah. Kalau kita tahu memang kita foresee dia ni
tak macam Wan kata lah tadi, tembak semua semua guna machine gun, brrrr, every bullet is every thoughts. If you want to sue someone under thought, you jangan kata thought saja, you boleh claim contract. You know, if it's involved something of a contractual punya element, claim. You know, so kalau lah kata you menang contract, apa, breach of contract, the damages that you suffered because of breach of contract as compared to tort, you kena pilih je, dia tak akan bagi dua-dua. You know, tort is to compensate, reinstate you to the second before the accident that took place. So compensation tak banyak. Okay, kalau medical cost, RM100,000, RM250, you akan dapat gitu je. Yeah, as to exact cent. Tapi kalau you menang contract dalam satu action, then the court have the right to give you that. Yeah? Kalau dia bagi contract punya breach of contract, then you can get more. Obviously, it can go to millions, you know, because of you can prove, you know, remember contract is just a piece of paper, right? A worthless paper. But once you sign, both of you sign on that particular paper, it becomes a promise, a binding promise, whereby you dah ada consensus at idem, you agree, right? So breach of promise is not about actually tearing the contract, but the concept, the promise itself has been breached, and therefore the contract value is 200 million. Just one piece of paper is 200 million. So the 200 million is the one that you are going to get. As compared to thought, then thought is just orang kata petty lah. Boleh? Ih, geram benda ni. Kacau lah. What is this? Sekejap eh. Oh, kenapa dia kat sini? Cannot. Dah dapat juga finally. Okay. Alright. Soalan lain? Ya, soalan lain. Bukan Jamie sahaja. Orang lain tak ada ke? Hampa tidur ke apa? Any questions that come across your mind that you want to clarify? Dia kan bila ada benda yang kita terlintas, tanya je, because you know, we don't want that to trouble. When you have something in your mind, you don't throw it out. Dia akan jadi mengganggu lah. Ya.
Sir.
Ya. Yeah.
Okay. Nak tanya sikit lah. Okay. Kalau let's say in a residential area, people use residential parking letak construction
materials,
machineries, macam tractors and so on in a residential area, is that falls under nuisance?
It happens only one night ke ataupun continuously?
Consistently, each and every day.
Then you can claim for public nuisance. So you ask the government to take care of that problem on your behalf. It is not only one person lah. You can approve many. So it is considered as a nuisance. Interference is your right. Tapi you have to prove lah in terms of what? Yeah, you have to prove some kind of damages. So what that, damages? Yeah.
That falls under local municipality kan?
Yes. So you buat complaint dekat majlis and the majlis will take action against that person. So ada satu case yang sat lagi yang kita akan go through, tapi nampak memang case tu ada dua tiga case actually when you fighting giants, right? Probability of you losing is very high. Itu yang kena class action kan? Biasa tengok yang that case Alan Brockovich apa nama the movie kan apa nama ini Julia Roberts I love that movie because
saya dah tengok 3-4 kali dah tu.
Kita ni orang yang suka justice kan, we like to see you know injustice to be thrown out. We don't like people to do injustices towards other people kan. So orang yang buat law ni selalu ni dia ada semangat dia tinggi lah as compared to other people. That's why you do law. Dalam case tu kan class action. So class action you pull money from people, right? So kata ada 1,000 orang as your client, then you have enough money for you to fight the giants. So that is the situation lah. In England, just to share, dia kata kat sini damages for personal injury per se is no longer available. Maksudnya the court in UK, the reason is that claim of negligence should be more appropriate cause of action. Meaning, if you were to claim under nuisance in UK, so the court might not be inclined towards giving you, you know, that compensation. Better for you to claim under negligence. Yeah, better for you to claim under negligence as compared to that. Tapi Malaysia masih open. So why? Because courts ni dia ada belas ihsan lah. Because lawyers ni kadang-kadang tak berapa pandai juga. Dia nak main hentam ya. Ambil kau. Langau penuh kat rumah. Where was I tadi? So kat mana? Mudah saya terlupa terus. The courts dekat UK dengan dekat Malaysia ni dia compensate sikit lah. Dia macam boleh lah, dia relax sikit. Because sometimes people, lawyers they claim under nuisance by right, dia claim tu sepatutnya under negligence lah, you know, better because you get a better case under negligence. Tapi dia claim under nuisance pun court kata okay, boleh lah, cara pejam sebelah mata je. Okay, so that is the position. Dekat England dah jadi cerita lain lah. Dia kata you buat claim on your clients under nuisance tapi damages tu is a big issue then chances are the court will reject your claim. So be careful, right? Okay, now kita masuk dekat dia punya test lah, yeah. So the interference, yeah, interference yang berlaku mestilah unreasonable, yeah. So there must be in issue of the first test is reasonableness of the activity. Okay, so ingat reasonableness in terms of what? In terms of the activity, yeah. So dia kata kat sini, because only the interference that is deemed unreasonable, yeah, will be considered as nuisance. So the first thing that you might want to make a note that is important about nuisance is to prove unreasonableness. Okay, so how do you check whether it is unreasonable or not? Itu subjective. You know, it is based on, as I mentioned, from case to case. So reasonableness in nuisance does not mean that whether the defendant has taken adequate precaution. So defendant ni selalu dia akan, kalau you become the lawyer for the defendant, so you can you want to prove that we have done all that is needed in order for us to avoid that kind of things. Or macam Jamie kata tadi, we have no idea about that that danger, you know. Here, nuisance does not mean that whether the defendant had taken adequate precaution to avoid the risk of the accident. It is the reasonableness of the thought of negligence, obviously, right? In thought of nuisance, reasonableness is measured. Nampak, they're not measuring yet. So kalau the court, when you feel, you go to the court, is about how the judge measure your unreasonableness of the client. So is measured by balancing the rights and interests of both parties. So the court akan nampak, as a judge, I will look at both parties. When they present the case, the plaintiff and the defendant, obviously the judge will come to a point that the balance has to be there. Yeah, in terms of the activity, in terms of the economic value, in terms of the, you know, the rights of a person, whether he has the right to be interfered with his enjoyment of the land and things like that. So it is a process of compromise. Yeah, compromise macam mana? It doesn't mean that kau kata ah, tak apalah, you diam lah, you know. But in a way, it is in a compromising punya situation. So, you know, benda ni siapa pun tak boleh menang 100%, right? So kalau you menang pun, it must be a middle way of things, yeah. So you just cannot 100% kata kilang tu tutup tu. Oh, saya Tuan Hakim, saya nak kilang tu tutup because dia nuisance towards me. I cannot sleep. I have lost my job because you know, I cannot perform, you know. So you want damages to the extent that the kilang is to be closed down. Doesn't make sense, you know. So there must be a middle way of doing things. Although defendant may be shown have taken all reasonable precaution, yeah, to prevent harm, this does not mean that defendant had acted reasonably for the purpose of nuisance. Nuisance, even though you take precaution, but if that particular act that you have done suffered the neighbor, the, I put neighbor sini kan, tak patutlah, better the plaintiff, eh? It can be far away, you know, it might be neighbor, boleh lah kita ambil lah, senang nak faham konsep, eh? So if it affects the plaintiff, which is very near to you, and you should also foresee, you know, that you are doing something that is going to be affecting, say for example 24 hours punya construction, right? Macam LRT yang tengah nak buat dekat yang third phase ni kan, third ke fourth phase. So if you have that activity that is towards the, apa orang kata, the inability for people to enjoy the nights, yeah, because itu jalan 24 jam, right? So does it goes to the extent that you are able to put the construction, to stop the construction completely? No, it does not go to the extent. Okay, so macam mana you nak buat? Kena ada contingencies lah. Mungkin 24 hours is to be reduced only sampai pukul 12 sampai pukul 6. You know, you minta the judge to give you some compensation in terms of stop work from 12 to 6. You know, not ataupun 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. It depends, eh? Because the benefit of that activity to the society is greater. So ini akan masuk konsep apa, utilitarian. Kalau ini belajar juris nanti, dia ada konsep of jurisprudence, eh? Utilitarianism, whereby any action that you do is going to benefit more people, then therefore the court will be favoring you because your intention is good. Okay, though it might cause people to suffer, it's just temporary. Yeah, so it's a minority against majority. So nanti belajar nanti, later on. Okay.
Itu yang the greatest happiness for the greatest number.
So Jeremy Bentham, greatest happiness of the greatest number of people. So happiness is about giving pleasure and avoiding pain. Yeah. So you, oh Jeremy dah belajar eh? The rest ada belajar lagi? Nanti kalau you belajar, oh, kalau tak belajar tak apa, it's okay. Bila you belajar juris ke mana-mana law ke, don't compartmentalize your mind. Yeah? So this is not a good for student of law. Kita ni nak belajar ilmu kita satu. Tapi dipecah-pecah untuk kita too easy for us to understand that particular law. We are looking at law of thought dalam satu subject. Subject is thought two. Tapi dalam thought two pun kita pecah lagi kan. So kita pecah-pecah ni because you the mode is trying to make you understand. Yeah. So but in total, kalau you keluar nanti, your action is towards the complete application of the law. Meaning every law comes at that point of time. Other than within that particular time of you doing your job, every law comes in. So you have to take into consideration. So you have to make sense. Kalau you nak lawan orang, kalau you nampak the justice apa, apa dia punya character, apa dia punya past decision yang dia pernah buat. You know, kalau you masuk dengan case trespass to person, battery, judge pula perempuan. Ha, you know, kalau case yang dia handle dulu, cases that is winning in terms of if you dah nampak inclination of the judge. Okay, so the chances of you to win. So it is all about technical understanding. Okay, kita tengok dah. I think kita sekejap. Kita nak kena break lah. 8:30. 9:30 kan? Oh, you want boleh break sekejap kan?
9:50 rasa.
Saat? Macam mana, Jeremy?
Ini dah 9:50 bukan 9:30.
Lebih dah kan. Okey, sekejap lagi kita habis yang ni. Kita stop dekat apa? Category of nuisance. Now, Syarikat Perniagaan Selangor and Fakhrul Rozi ya. Here the judge Chan Min Tat. Almost everyone of us has to tolerate certain amount of interference, kan? Because you duduk dalam keadaan neighborhood, ya. Yeah? So kalau neighborhood you kata I nak aman. Tak boleh lah, you know. So there are things yang kita terpaksa tolerate, yeah? But what do you mean by I need to tolerate everything? Macam tadilah, renovation untuk apartment bolehlah buat daripada apa pukul 9 sampai pukul 5. Yang kami duk bengang selalu ni, kalau pukul 6 masih duk elan lagi. Okay, saya akan keluar rumah, saya menjeritlah. Saya kata stupid. All this mencarut keluar lah. Dan saya kadang-kadang saya bawa parang, ya. Parang naik memang salah.
Saya
bawa parang. Walaupun kita ada guard and sometimes the guard is not. Kadang-kadang guard ni
tak. Serius ke?
Ya.
Parang.
Parang. You know, kita macam they are not considerate, they are not being very considerate, yeah, because you are living in this environment. Please consider lah kan. Kita nak buat benda pun kita fikir. So certain people doesn't understand. So you have to push use force. Those who knows the law are the one that breach the law, betul tak? Bawa tu dah memang salah lah. Kita tahu. Tapi orang tak tahu kata benda yang bawa tu salah tu kita bawa aja. Saja je saya bawa pergi tebas pokok-pokok kat depan rumah saya.
We learn from the best. We learn from the best.
Remember when you are doing something, you know, you must be able to have some way out of doing things. Okay? Kalau saya bawa kereta, bawa kereta, kita ada lori baru ni saya balik kampung, datang lane tengah duk bagi high beam. Okay, tak guna kau. Okay, saya bawa slower tapi disebabkan kita bahaya, kita ingat your wife, right? You have to remember your family member. pergi ke tepi, bila horn dia terus nak apa, nak kira, nak kita nak cari gaduh. Okey, tak apa, cari gaduh, aku ada kamera, you know, I have my students. Yang kerja merata, polis pun ada, dekat JPJ pun ada, it's just a matter of time. I buatlah perangai, I can always record and give it to them and ask them, tolong, you are my student kan, take action kan. So, you must be able to use your mind lah, okay.
Tapi right. Bully ni memang saya, I selalu rasa middle finger tu normal lah saya, geram yeah. Betul.
The ability for you to put apa orang panggil blinds, yeah, ada study, yeah. Kalau you go online, ya, yeah, ada study yang dah buat. Memang rude bully ni dia akan jadi less if that person doesn't see your face. Okay, so bila kita ni sebenarnya bila kita nampak tu yang nak cari gaduh tu, bila kita nampak muka face to face, right? So moral of the story is to be able to hide, yeah.
So it should be allowed to tinted the thing, the car. I agree, sir.
Agree. Tapi I pun ada agree-nya, ada tak agree-nya. Okay. Right. Apa ni? Sekejap, eh.
Right. Sebelum saya teruskan, nak tanya. Okay. Yeah. Kan kalau untuk nuisance ni kan, okay, it's more on the land. It's the occupier's liability of, okay, that person. Sebab dekat sini I terbaca yang dekat the concept of reasonableness ni. So even though dia dah took all those preventive action and everything, kalau sebab macam occupier's liability kan, if he's is possible things to happen, dia dah try to prevent whatever is possible kan. But even though dia dah buat benda tu, still it still doesn't stop from the purpose of a nuisance. Still nuisance tetap juga boleh raise that issue.
Boleh.
So contoh that means occupier's liability versus the nuisance, still nuisance is over that. Is that?
Dia occupier's liability, since you have learned occupiers kan. So the owing of the person, say for example the defendant here kan, say for example you masuk highway, yeah, if you are entering as the apa licensee as compared to contractual entrance, obviously the owing of the defendant punya duty towards you is higher as compared to licensee. Kalau kita ambil contoh, you masuk you bayar toll as compared to motor yang masuk yang tak bayar toll. So the duty of the highway authorities towards these two are different. Say for example you ada bangkai, ya, kalau ada bangkai binatang dekat tengah jalan and you elak and then you suffer accident. So the duty of the highway authorities towards you is more as compared to motorcycle. So jadi di situ as occupiers of that particular highway, yeah, you pay and you enter into that land. So the defendant, meaning the owner of the land, must be taking more precaution. Yeah, ada case kat bawah ni. If you read about this guy, an Indian chap, dia masuk highway and then ada lembu. Yeah, lembu mati, lembu hidup dekat highway. So dia try a lot accident, you know. So nuisance tu macam mana in terms of occupiers juga. So as I already mentioned, occupiers pun you boleh claim, you know, the thought of occupiers, eh, in order for you to claim for nuisance, it's up to you, yeah. So as I mentioned, machine gun, yeah, macam Wan kata, machine gun, brr, you know, make sure that everything you are able to claim je. Did I answer you, Jamie?
Answer, yeah, macam so. Okay, tak apa. Bermakna walaupun kita dah buat all those preventive measure, still if it's nuisance can be rise a bit from that.
Macam lembu tu datang juga kan, it's considered as nuisance lah. Kalau lah kata lembu tu selalu duduk lintas jalan, right? And then they have done their best, their best to stop the lembu by the pagar and things like that. But pagar selalu duduk kena ceroboh, right? So they have not gone to that extent. They have done their best to put the fences up. So therefore, lembu tak boleh cross. You know, orang jahat nak buat macam mana kan? Tapi the fact that the court akan nampak, nuisance berlaku tak? Okay, kalau kata you can prove that the number of instances of things that occur, lembu tu banyak kali dah you perasan dekat, sampai dekat kilometer ni memang selalu. Macam saya dekat golf course yang tepi highway dekat nak going north tu, apa dia, apa nama tempat tu, Batang Berjuntai. Mana lembab tu? Ada golf course kan? You perasan on your belakangan. So situ penuh dengan monkey. Baru ni saya kena langgar monkey. Tu yang disebabkan saya tukar kereta. Sebab kereta masalah banyak kan? Sebuang body. going back recently, ada dua monkey mati tengah jalan. So they have to do something. They means the authority. If you knew that the incident taken place of that kilometer is quite high, then you cannot be justifying in saying that saya dah buat pagar lah. Hey, what do you mean by pagar? Monyet dia tak perlu pagar. Kalau lembu, yes. But when it comes to monyet, so monyet is the one that you should anticipate, because benda ni bukan berlaku sekali. You know, dah berlaku banyak kali. Sebab macam mana you nak tahu? Sebab banyak sangat binatang yang dah mati kat situ, monyet. So what have you done? So di situ the court akan tengok lah. The argument that you kata, oh saya dah buat dah segala-galanya, apa yang, no, it is not enough. Apa yang you kena buat ialah maybe ni buat jaring, you know, jaring whereby they are able to cross and not crossing on the road, rather the off the road, meaning ada some kind of kat flyover kan, buatlah something, you know, di mana dia orang boleh pakai. Dekat Amerika, dia orang buat jejantas specifically untuk binatang lalu, you know. You masuk dalam YouTube, I rasa seronok dia tengok je. Dia orang ni, they think forward because they sayang, ya. Yeah? The Christians talks about love. Banyak, kita ni banyak love tapi tak application tu kurang. Dia orang sampai buat highway in order for the animals to cross over. Kita ada highway. Kalau kita tengok highway Pantai Timur pula. I think Pantai Timur ada satu.
Kita ada
dekat
North Lembu Pintas.
Baru nak kata tau, kita letak dekat tepi highway ada signboard lembu. Itu je, maknanya dia dah nak.
Dia tak boleh letak Chinese lembu tu. You knew that lembu is there. How come you put and you ask us to be cautious? Tak boleh. Tak boleh. That is wrong concept altogether. Macam trespass to land kan. You ada orang kata tunjuk kata, tembak. That is totally wrong. Yeah. So he can sue them for doing something that is wrong. Boleh nampak ya? So in that particular case, in my situation, actually I can sue highway authorities and saying that you have not done, you know. Does not mean that you have to completely eradicate that problem, but at least ada mitigation lah, mesti ada contingencies, middle way of doing things. Susah eh? Tapi itulah, kalau you nak take action, the process is tedious. Yeah, it is not simple enough for us to take action against other people. You nak berkelahi ya. Kalau nak berkelahi ni memang susah lah. Saya banyak kali berkelahi ya. Ada yang menang, ada yang kalah. Kadang-kadang rasa letih. You know, macam mana? Somebody has to do it, right? Okay, before kita stop ni, sikit ya. You have to strike a balance. Now, you means the judge lah, they have to strike a balance. You, on your part as a lawyer, you have to prove that this problem that is being faced, kalau you on the plaintiff side, is totally different from what normally people would suffer. Yeah, this is a special situation. Tapi kalau you on the defendant, kata ah itu biasa je, bukannya benda apa pun, you know, normal people would suffer that. So it is the judge to strike a balance. Yeah, and then balance of what? So how to do that? Dia mesti ada test lah, kan? Because other courts akan pakai the same thing, the same law, the same application. So there is no universal formula, yeah, that we can rely on, but a useful test in terms of reasonableness is being applied. So what is accepted as reasonable is depending on the case to case punya basis. What is in that particular society? So in our society, the certain standard, yeah, in our society is different from other societies. You cannot say to similarize those in UK as compared to here, because certain things are different. Yeah. So in UK, the test is different. It might not be the same with the test that we apply here. So what needs to be taken into consideration then? Ni semua ni lah. Defendant conduct macam mana? Location macam mana? Location proximity in terms of apa? Location, yeah. And then location juga, kalau you duduk dekat apartment, kalau you duduk rumah you dekat dengan sebelah kilang, you know, kalau you duduk dekat dalam hutan, di mana orang tebang pokok, you know, pukul 2 pagi dia pun nak, ataupun tembak binatang pukul 2 pagi, you know, location is a factor that you can bring to the court. Time, you know, time that it takes place, you know, location, time tadi, eh, location and the time. So location, walaupun orang kata you are staying dekat dalam jungle in order for you to run away from all this nuisance, tapi still nuisance datang dekat you, then you look at that in terms of the location and also the time. Extent of damages, kalau damages dia teruk sampai you kena masuk hospital 6 bulan, that is a good way of proving your case. The way in which the interference occurs, the interference will occur every second as compared to every week, you know. That is the balancing yang court akan take into consideration. Motif dengan malice. Ini apa Jamie suka ni, motif dengan malice is more towards criminal, eh? Tapi if you can prove it, then it would be a good way of you winning your case lah, eh? Not to say that it's very difficult for you to prove motive and malice, yeah. Tapi kita tengok the facts, yeah. The facts res judicata, meaning the facts talks to by itself. You don't have to like cari benda, yeah. So it's better for you to utilize certain things that is apa, that is simple in order for you to win case. Tapi kalau you nak win the case, you can prove malice, then you can prove motive, yeah. If you have evidence, why not? By all means, yeah. Okay, so we take a break sekejap. Okay, siapa yang nak tanya soalan, boleh tanya soalan. Oh, undur sikit sir, nak tanya, can defense lawyer side England case? Yeah, so if you don't have authorities, Malaysian authorities, meaning case dekat Malaysia yang courts dah decide, meaning the decision of that law is coming from the higher courts, yeah. The higher courts become, yeah, kita belajar MLS kan. So then this is the provision under Civil Law Act, eh, section 3 and 5 can come in, yeah. The UK law will come. Why? Because the English knows that when we receive our independence, it is all everything new. So they cannot impose their law anymore. But if you have a problem that you need to settle, you still can borrow from us the principle. If you want to create your own principle, your court want to create your own principle, by all means you can do that. Okay. But if you are having any problem, tak boleh, then you take. Yeah. So okay, guys, kita break set 5 minit. Jumpa balik pukul 8:10. 15 minit, berapa minit? Max saya teruk betul. Berapa minit eh? Campur 15, 25. 25, 10, 25. 15 minit. Ampun, you can do everything that you want. Anyone who wants to ask any question while everyone else take a break? Jamie, ada soalan? Kalau ada soalan, letak kat sebelah eh. Saya off mute. Tapi Jamie, apa kalau nak tanya soalan.
So
yes, anything.
So nak tanya pasal depends on definition. Ada formula mudah tak so macam kita nak tahu which is which yang kita boleh pakai.
Tak I tak dengar apa you cakap tadi.
Untuk definition. Ada for defense untuk defamation ada formula mudah tak sir untuk kita kaitkan dia falls bawah this kind of defense.
Different
defense.
Okay, right.
Ada formula yang mudah untuk kita yang setahu yang mungkin saya ada create ke so that nanti bila kita jumpa soalan defamation dalam final paper nanti oh so kita boleh terus pakai okay ni defense dia bawah consent contohnya.
Tak boleh.
Tak ada.
Dia macam ni, defense ni dia macam bila you pernah main kad tak?
Kat Uno pernah lah sir.
Uno apa yang special card yang you akan simpan?
Yang ada banyak color tu apa?
Dia macam tu lah. Dia kena ada. Maksudnya you punya defense ni semua you kena faham. Semua ada, duduk ada sebelah aja. It's just a matter of you nak choose and pick and you know pakai.
Okay. Sebab takut kita tersalah pilih defense.
Itu yang it shows whether you understand the defense or not. The way I will spot you not being able to understand is where you use different tools for different things. You know, you nak drill satu lubang aja, kan? Tapi you guna jack yang besar tu. So actually drill yang kecil je. So bila you pakai tools, it shows whether you understand or not. So dalam court nanti later on, di sini tak penting sangat. You know, dalam court nanti later on, it will show whether you are a good lawyer or not. So, there is no formula. What you have to do is to, apa kata, get familiarized with the concept of the defense tu. You kena, semua ada. Maksudnya you tahu. Bila nak pakai, baru you check. Yang ni mungkin, you know, justification in terms of justification. Is it justification? Check the law. Dalam you jadi lawyer nanti later on, the same thing that you are going to apply. Doesn't mean that you know everything. Kapal Singh tak tahu semua, you know. he likes those people yang mengaku kata dia tak tahu, because so so many laws that you, that is out there. So what you need to do is ingat je certain apa remedies ataupun certain action. So daripada situ detail dia kita cari lah.
Tapi kalau
saya
in most mostly dalam final paper kan sir, yang membuat soalan ni dia prone untuk letak defense lebih daripada satu ke sir?
Depends. You pandai nak pakai defenses tu banyak lebih daripada satu. Kadang-kadang kita bukan nak minta apa compensation saja. Say for example, orang dah defame you, you nak compensation. Macam saya baru ni saya cakap dengan dekan about defamation towards me kan. Yang student kata I bagi my wife tanda, kata I want a apology. That is you know, if you you know when we had the discussion about the problem, I spoke to the dean and the timbalan dekan and things like that, and Puan Mazlifah pun Mazlifah So I said to me, I'm very simple. I just want her to ask for apology, and it was it is to be done through the website of UiTM, meaning the faculty in your website. That is what I want. Okay. I don't know whether action has been taken or not, but I have already asked. That is my compensation that I wanted. I don't want money. You know, what's the point of going asking for money? But if you are the lawyer, so you can ask for money, you ask for removal of that, you know, injunction. You ask for injunction to stop that person from doing that anymore. Normally, contingency lah. You kata, you jangan buat lagi. Because the information is, you know, something yang sono juicy, people you want to sono cerita jahat dengan orang lain, and then on top of that you minta apology. So it is up to you to choose which one do you want. All do you want all pun boleh, you want one pun boleh, or several pun boleh, it's up to you.
Satu soalan assignment tu, pasal assignment kan, dalam soalan tu dia minta kita advise assender. Jadi kita advise dia sama ada kita keluarkanlah poin-poin apa yang mili libel ataupun slander, and then perlu tak kita masukkan
perlu
four factors in in assessing the damages ke?
This is, remember what we are doing is actually a practice. Nanti later on, baru you nak try, you have to explore. Because kalau lah kata, for example, kalau kita tak pentingkan benda tu, you are not going to be a complete person as a lawyer. We don't want you to do things and then suddenly people tanya, mana dia belajar law tu? ITM, patut. You jangan rosakkan I punya nama.
Okay.
Kalau orang kata siapa aja lotok tu kat dia orang tu, kat mamat ni, hari, teruk betul hari. Jangan buat leceh. So, I want you guys to explore, use your thinking and whatever logic that comes into your mind untuk you nak pakai, go ahead. You know, not, no one is to restrict you and say that, oh ini case ni kena pakai ni. Ini no, it's not. Salah lah saya kalau saya ajar in that sense. I want you to be able to explore. Nothing is in the book yang kita belajar so far ni is considered as determination. Okay. So meaning tak boleh lah kata this one kena ada, this one kena tak. Yeah, you just use your own logic. That is much better, because if you are doing that, oh, you are my student, right? Kalau susah, student kadang-kadang dia just nak pass exam je.
Ataupun ni semua nak ringkas dan cepat.
Semua nak A, kan? You nak A. Saya so, tak fikir.
Betul.
Tengok masa depan. Yes, saya.
Sajalah nak tanya.
Yes, yes, yes. Boleh?
Apa yang soalan untuk assignment 2 tu, sir?
Aha.
Yang tu basically diambil daripada past year's exams kan? Exam question.
Yes, yes. Past year's exam.
Ha. Tapi kan, sir, soalan tu macam kalau jawab dalam dewan peperiksaan, saya rasa banyak masa habis tu.
Masa habis setengah jam yang pertama, paper kosong.
Tak faham. Ni tak patutlah saya buat benda ni. Tapi it's a, apa orang kata? It's progressive commentary, comments lah. The way I see it, things that you are killing the student now, but
ha, itulah. Soalan tu macam tak mau bagi student pass
lah. Ha? Memang itu yang saya kata. It is the, apa orang kata, the metaphor, bukan metaphor, the dynamic of the learning, yeah, is about understanding, right? So you nak, bukan nak bunuh dia orang, you bukan nak, they are not lawyers yet. So and then on top of that, your standard, mungkin you doctor, mungkin you are the master, they are just learning how to, you kena ambil generalize lah, those ada dalam kelas yang ada doctor, ada yang professional. So don't take them as a standard. Now, take a person yang baru nak start belajar kan, about a law that is baru, benda ni baru, kenapa you nak buat torture macam tu? Tak faham lah.
Saya rasa macam menang trofi kalau student tak pas cangkul.
Kita ada kita punya prinsipal, di mana kita punya motto, ataupun bukan motto, kita panggil kita punya vision. ITM punya vision is to make sure that people are industrial based, meaning when you go out the industry, you will say who ITM student number one. So just because you want to have that does not mean that you have to make life difficult. Yeah, understanding is much better as compared to, well, kita ni silap approach lah, the way I see it. Okay. Kita sepatutnya pakai Finland punya approach. You belajar mana you nak tahu.
Ada exam. Tak payah ada exam, sir.
Ada exam. Pasal apa
pula ada exam? I don't believe in exam. I never believe in exam. It's so
people
wrong.
People like me, macam saya kan. Saya ada penyakit kan. I'm dyslexic. So dyslexic punya, memang to me nak belajar law, ya Allah, Tuhan saja ketahui. Sebab bila baca, dyslexic ni dia baca bila sampai hujung nak pergi the second line, you dah lost. You know, that is my problem. I cannot remember names because macam Jamie, I boleh ingat nama you sebab talks one pun, and then you are the one that active. Had the rest, tobat I tak boleh ingat. So macam mana I boleh ingat nama-nama case? Oh, memang problem gila. You know? Sorry,
belakang
kanan, saya tak ingat saya.
Siapa tu? Seorang tak ingat?
Kecil.
Jamie dengan Syahimi. Syahimi kenal lah. Because ni, orang kata turn left. Turn left, mana left lah? Ni left. Ni left. You know, that dyslexia ni dia memang perangai macam tu lah. So, but still, I boleh kata kat you, kalau you rasa you are dyslexic ke, ada problem ke, saya dah buat PhD pun. So, memanglah problematic people macam saya kan, tapi nak buat macam mana? Life is not always a piece of green pastures, eh? Still ada problem.
So propose lah, sir, kalau untuk subjek law ni, kalau exam, final exam, is open book test. Mana ada orang lawyer yang buat practical, dia pergi doa hafal case, dia pergi semua refer kat buku, everything.
Memang pun.
Patutnya, open book test is something that is, I think, is even in Australia they did that. Mana ada orang, ni kat Malaysia je, dia menghafal, dia terus menghafal, tapi it doesn't mean that you understand.
It does not reflect you as when you are out there, kan? When you are out there, you are open to do whatever you want. You want online resources ke, you ask people ke, you look at the books. So So somehow they just want to make life difficult and try you to memorize things, which is ridiculous, right? Kalau you buat juga macam tu, which I believe memang you all akan setuju kan? I tanya you soalan. After this exam, after all the exam that you have undertaken, the next day you still remember tak apa yang you jawab semalam?
Contoh sebagi apa pink pistol tu last semester sampai sekarang ingat lagi kan? Benda-benda macam tu boleh lah kan, something significant. Tapi kalau benda yang you read, you're not gonna remember the whole book. That's impossible.
Impossible, yes, Jamie, betul, impossible. And you kita panggil ni ya, kita pedagogi ya, the pedagogy of teaching is different as compared to what we are supposed to. It is more towards memorizing as compared to understanding. The one that we want to test is about the understanding rather than tak faham tu. Tapi itulah, inilah yang sepatutnya Minister of Education have to think rather than apa nama minister tu ya? Nama tak ingat. Siapa? Mazi.
Perenggam tu sir, dia I punya YB kat sini sir, okay?
Dia sepatutnya, what he is supposed to do is to revamp education system in terms of bukannya cakap pasal kasut putih ke kasut hitam.
Betul.
Sorry lah, kita ni banyak komen kan, tapi kalau kita kena buat, mampus kita tak boleh buat. The way I see it, you are supposed to talk about the changes to the system. Changes to the system of education yang kita ada. Education in terms of awareness, in terms of understanding, you know. Belajar law, law memang law subject tak ada. It should be introduced. The rights of, duties and rights of all citizens. Kita ajar dekat primary school, lagi dah ada. Apa yang orang fight, abuse dalam kelas. Apa ni panggil?
Bullying.
Bullying, ya. Yeah. Okay, rights of bullying, bullying tak ada. Rights of sexual harassment tak ada. My wife baru ni, dia baru teringat because girls ni, dia try to remove the mind, the things that happens to them. Eh? So, the suppression of the mind of all the things yang negative. So, dia memang kalau tengok cerita-cerita law ni, because she is a lecturer of law juga kan. So, dia more towards justice lah. Marah bila tengok benda, especially sexual harassment. Ish. Something is wrong. You must be actually abused, you know. Memang betul baru ni dia kata, now I remember lah, I have been sexually abused. Dia kata, siapa abuse tu? If that person is still available, then kita cari pasangan dia. You know, teacher dia, you know, teacher dekat primary school, pegang dia punya private parts. Kadang-kadang, ni is not only her, to all students. And that guy, tak tahulah dia hidup lagi ke tak. Tapi saya nak memang saja nak cari pasal lah. Saja nak cari gaduh kan. Tapi dia dah pension obviously. Tak tahu mati ke tak. When she was young, like 40 years ago, right? So, dia pegang private parts, perempuan. You know? Pegang meaning the tweet lah. How can you do that?
Sexual harassment.
Sexual harassment, right? So the student must be able to be exposed of their rights. Tak ada pun. Tak ada siapa nak ajar pun. You know? Kenapa tak ada dalam syllabus? It is important information for your life. Why belajar? I tak faham belajar maths, at maths. I fail at maths. I dapat 9. Because I don't understand. Kenapa you kena memorize this formula? For what? I cannot relate. You belajar satu konsep maths and then the practicality dia tak tunjuk tau. Kenapa you belajar maths ni, fizik ni, chemistry ni, apa relationship of those knowledge to your life? Yeah? Practicality dia tak nampak. So you should kan, semua orang faham je. Eh, tak faham. Dia tak faham, dia reject.
You crack your mind for nothing.
Yes. Kalau lah kata, oh, nanti satu hari you akan face in this situation whereby you need to know about this. Okay. So for example, AdMats, the application of AdMats in terms of your daily life, macam mana. So practice, the syllabus have to be changed. Ada, to me maintain AdMats, tak apa. But as long as you are able to make sense of the lesson that you learn. So dekat kalau tak ada.
Dekat Malaysia ni exam oriented, so exam oriented based.
Itulah. Itulah.
It's not about the application.
Ya, yeah, betul. So kita punya konsep silap. Tapi siapalah saya kan?
Sama lah sir. I masa kelas juris, I told Prof Syed about the moral ethics. At least macam kita punya MBMB, kita punya whatever minister tu, YB yang kat parlimen tu, at least they have a certain level of moral ethics knowledge, you know, the minimum standard. Bukannya macam acting like that as in a zoo dekat parlimen. Dah macam it doesn't represent us, doesn't represent any of us and everything lah. I think that is the same thing to the basic of the education system as well. Mana ada kalau dekat, I still remember when I was still dekat Austria dulu kan, my kids, dia orang tak akan ajar ABC not until they are 7 years old. If you are 7 years old, you are not, you anak I tak tahu baca not until they are 7, because they don't introduce all those learning thing. But it doesn't mean that they are stupid. Still, they can catch up all those basic learning. Tapi kalau dekat Asia ni, what I can see is that 2-3 tahun masuk tadika, belikan buku and everything. I mean, that is not the concept. You are children, you need to play. You have to grow as a human. But when you, I don't know, it's a mental torture, I think, in Asia. That's it.
Kejap kita apa, kita cari YouTube tak? I suka ni. So saja share dengan you all lah. Boleh kan ni?
Boleh.
Ah ni, I suka ni. Saya ambil beberapa minit. 9 minit boleh?
Boleh.
Ada, boleh dengar tak?
Tak dengar.
Sekejap.
Okay, I rasa kalau Finland Education, I banyak dah tengok video dia sah.
Ah, just to give a comparative punya analysis eh.
Because America actually they are trying to learn from Finland, so they send their apa education, apa dia macam teacher dia orang ke Finland to learn. Malaysia pun hantar juga rasa, Maslimalik hantar
sendiri. Itu semua main-main je.
Kita ni banyak shock sendiri je. Ya.
Betul? Allah, tak boleh lah. Kadang-kadang dia ni, tak bagi lah. Tak boleh nampak. Tapi you tengok ni, tengok dia punya graf kan? Education rank kan? Allah.
Zed, you tak tunjuk screen je.
Oh, tak tunjuk screen. Sekejap. Oh, ni ada.
So here.
Dia kadang-kadang putus ya. Sorry. Mi, boleh dengar?
Ya. Boleh?
Boleh ya?
Boleh dengar tapi dia dah start lagging sikit.
Lagging ya? Tak apalah. So nanti I bagi link ni.
Boleh.
I give you the link so you can go and look at it.
Dah tengok dah ni sir. I dah tengok.
Kan? Tambah you dah exposed to that environment. So it changed us, the nature of our insight. So
anak I dulu pergi sekolah, dia pergi 7:30, 12:30 dia dah balik dah. Lepas tu that's it, kat rumah homework, and then teacher dia will say never ever disturb your children like apa ask them to do homework, or if they do anything, let's say calculation, you don't interfere, let them do themselves. Kalau kat sini everybody nak
antar boy, kita ada sistem. I used to work dekat Ericsson, Ericsson kan, Sweden kan. Dia pukul 5, okay, that's it, go home. Eh, ada kerja ni tak habis, never mind. You know, they don't expect you to like macam Jepun, you have to stay back. Uh-huh. And then until malam, kalau you balik awal, something is wrong with you. Tapi dia orang yang waktu I dengan Ericsson, still remember, ya Allah, bestnya.
Tapi betul je, sama. Even my time dulu, my manager dia akan tunggu depan pintu, halau semua balik.
Sebab apa dia kata tau? Kata you are not going to be productive if you stay, meaning you are not productive. You don't know what you're doing.
Lepas tu dia siap tanya siapa yang staying late apa semua, justify lah kenapa nak stay late.
Betul, because
is the law that actually you cannot work more than 40 hours a week. And then so every Friday tu is a half day. So I can see, every Friday dia orang balik pukul 12:30, it's a half day. And if you want to ask your employees to kerja more than 40 hours a week, you need to have approval, you know.
Not easy. Semua ni dia kita buat tracing, kalau semua law yang kita nampak dekat Europe ni, dia punya tracing is about jurisprudence, and then because everything is about law kan, you want to change everything got to do with law. So once the jurisprudence punya perspektif, for those yang tak belajar lagi jurisprudence, you akan nampak dia punya relationship of all the activities yang kita ada dalam dunia ni. So what happened was they have enough of the war that they suffered. The First World War, dia orang suffer banyak. Second World War, dia orang yang banyak suffered. So they say enough is enough. They don't want that to happen again. They discovered that the war happened because terlampau over sangat, over zealous in terms of to make things progress. You know, dia bahaya kalau progress banyak sangat ni, you don't relax. Macam tadi dalam video ni kata, they have to learn how to be happy, you know, how to be happy is just let them be and they will discover. Orang Melayu, kalau kita tengok kebanyakan kita dalam kelas ni semua, kebanyakannya Melayu kan. So orang Melayu dia punya skill is towards, dia perasan it's not education, tetapi on doing new things or inventing. Orang Melayu memang dia pandai kat situ. So that should flourish because education is suppressing this so-called innovative punya element. So you talk about innovation lah, apalah, mengarut because the method that you apply does not quite encourage. Yeah? Allah.
The system encourages us to invent stories.
Invent stories. Aduh. So stressful in the. So kalau orang kata tak nak stress, pergilah kerja dekat ataupun pindah dekat European countries.
Senang je kan?
Ya. Tapi but kalau you tengok jurisprudence doesn't mean, kalau you tengok one of the, ada nampak muka dia, Karim remember his name. What you need to do is to change lah. And we cannot go, and every one of us cannot go and live in Europe, but doesn't mean that we cannot change and make, you know, things change better for us, for everyone else. Yeah, for those orang kaya, they boleh pergi, macam African countries, you know, those people who are poor, they want to change their life, they want to work to Europe, but they suffered, you know, the risk of dying when crossing the sea. So many of them died. Okay, kita sambung. Right. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Categories of nuisance. Yeah, category of nuisance, dia ada dua, which is public nuisance dengan private nuisance. So let's look at the public nuisance. Public nuisance is more towards interference with the public right. Meaning, as the citizens of Malaysia, you are a person that is living in this country, obviously the law or the federal constitution give you the right to enjoy your existence in Malaysia. So therefore you have
share screen.
Oh, share screen. Okay, so category of nuisance ada dua, public and private. So let's look at into public first. Interference with public rights. What do you mean by public rights? Because as already mentioned, as citizens, we have the right. We have the right to enjoy our existence as a Malaysian citizen. Meaning you have the right to life, your fundamental or basic fundamental liberties. Yeah, you are to enjoy your life as a citizen. Dengar tak? Kenapa ni? Oh.
Okay.
Okay. So, interference with public rights. As citizen, kita janganlah. We have every rights to enjoy public highways. Public highways yang tak bayar tol, highway number, kita ada numbering of highways kan. So state, kita ada state roads, kita ada private roads, state roads, ada federal roads. So federal roads, highway route number 1, number 2, number 3 apa semua tu, kita consider as highways, public highways. So you have the right to enjoy. Kalau dia kata situ 80 km, you have every rights to enjoy that 80 km/h. As compared to those obstruction yang di mana you are not able to enjoy, in terms of orang buat lubang, you know, causing difficulties and things like that, you cannot enjoy. That is wrong. Contaminated foods, you know, that is against our rights to get good food because we pay. And this one ada relationship with contractual element, but still you can have element of good food. Ada yang nak saman under private nuisance. The other day yang KFC, I think 10 years ago, KFC dia slaughter, house slaughter yang company yang supply dekat dia, it was discovered that from the facts, people who are working there have given videos, you know, ayam tu tak mati lagi sebab dia kena panaskan ayam tu. Cruelty je lah. Dia panaskan, bagi dia pengsan and then dia semelih. So kebanyakan ni bila dia panaskan, nak bagi dia pengsan, dah mati. Dia actually bangkai. So Muslim not happy with the process. So they you know, nak saman. So kalau nak saman private nuisance, you must be able to prove that you suffered, you know. You have to have that relationship, the nexus ataupun relationship. If you are unable to do that, then you are not able to win your case. So ada lawyer ni nak saman, nak saman under private nuisance. Dia kata, mana boleh private nuisance? Yeah, you have to prove damages. But in terms of this, public nuisance is much better. Okay, so public nuisance ni macam mana? Nuisance would only be created if knowing or having the means of knowing the existence. Yeah. So macam mana yang macam Jamie tanya tadi, how do you know whether that person know that activities yang dia buat boleh mendatangkan bahaya untuk orang lain? So you use the reasonable manner. It is unreasonable, you know, continue for unreasonable time. In this case, unreasonable circumstances. So from the perspective of reasonable man test, you tengok the circumstances of the activity is unreasonable. The circumstances of the time that is occurring is also unreasonable. Okay. For example, dalam sini, dia bagi example, adjoining a tree adjoining the highway falls into the highway. So without negligence. So can that amounts to what you call it, public nuisance? So in this situation, it is not considered as public nuisance unless you compare for those yang tinggal barang. So here pipes were pipes of sharp edges were left on the side of the highways for 1 or 2 years. You know, this is something that is unreasonable. Why it is unreasonable? Come on, as a person who put the things there, don't you think that it is something unreasonable for you to put it? You might be saying that tak kacau apa pun, tapi does it expose someone to possibility of danger? Any reasonable person would see that. So why don't you remove it in the first place? Compared to tree, orang tak tahu kata tree itu boleh tumbang. Memanglah tree boleh tumbang kat tepi highway kan. You know, macam mana? Sometimes it takes apa natural event untuk angin kuat sangat, eh, dia tak tahan patah masuk ke highway. But as compared to those, I mean, thing new things that you of unnatural things that you put onto something in terms of macam ni dia tunjuk highway, subjek dia sama highway, tapi objek dia lain, ya, yeah? Objek dia tree, objek dia barang yang apa bahaya, ya, yeah? In terms of pipes. So di sini court, walaupun instances dia subjek dia sama, objek dia akan menyebabkan perbezaan of the decision of the court. Sebab compare dua-dua ni, it is about reasonableness. Okay. So jadi macam mana, nak tengok definition sekejap. Dalam general PYA queries, public nuisance is where an act materially, yeah, maksudnya you can measure, yeah, effects the reasonable comfort and convenience. Jadi apa maksud comfort? You kena tengok the reasonable man. What is normal comfort of a normal person in the society? Katalah you duduk sebelah kilang, ya, yeah? Macam myself, kita ada maybe about kawasan ni maybe 10,000 orang, ya, yeah? Yang baru, bangunan-bangunan baru yang kalau dekat kilang gula CSR, yeah? Kalau you tengok building yang naik kat kawasan keliling CSR memang banyak. Okay, so maybe about 10,000 of us. If you were to sign petition to take action against CSR for emission of apa, sugar punya smell, does it mean that they have to abide? So jadi what is reasonable? Yeah, you yang datang kemudian, so tak boleh lah nak kata CSR have to change. Ataupun kat belakang saya ada kilang apa, kilang Carlsberg, eh, Carlsberg tu tak boleh lah kata kata, oh, Carlsberg, you are the one that causing us jadi pening, you know, lalu. Okay, that is comfort and convenience, yeah, of that particular class of the society. Ni saya letak Majlis Pembandaran Pulau Pinang, I just give you the facts lah. Okay, di mana diorang Majlis Pembandaran take action against this boy siutan for apa, doing a business, yeah, in terms of jual makanan, yeah. So this one is on public nuisance, yeah. They sue on public nuisance. Tapi bila based on public nuisance, diorang sebenarnya menang, first instance diorang menang, yeah. Tapi when it went up, apa, the contest is that they are wrong in terms of asking for public nuisance. Public nuisance ni yang boleh buat ialah AG sahaja. So anyone or any institution dalam Majlis Pembandaran Pulau Pinang is considered as institution lah, legal institution kan, dia macam orang juga. So anyone who wants to sue somebody else under public nuisance mesti dapat AG punya approval. Okay, kalau dia tak nak, dia nak, dia AG lambat, so the AG ada some kind of malafide ke, you know, AG kan banyak benda yang dia tak mau take into action. So you want to take action on your own, so you must be able to show special damages that you suffered. Okay, and you must be more than one, yeah, it must be two or more. So you can take private action. So in this case, what happened, Majlis Pembandaran Pulau Pinang is one person taking under the action of public nuisance, which is minimum requirement dua. So on technicality, memang dia orang kalah lah. First instance dia orang menang, injunction was given to prevent Busiu from doing apa, tempat makan tu. But later on, it was argued, kata mana boleh on technicality that they are taking public nuisance as a cause of action. Because kalau nak ambil public nuisance, the requirement must be through AG. You know, public. Who represent the public is AG. You know, AG yang decide sama ada one person to be taken action against or not. So AG represent the society. How can you as a member of the society take public nuisance? Public nuisance is to prove that something is wrong by the action of the defendant. So it went up, and then it went up to federal court, if I'm not mistaken. So the argument, when they lost the appeal, Majlis ni, they lost the appeal. When they went up, they argued that they are not taking action by virtue of apa orang kata, public nuisance. They are taking action by virtue of the provision of municipal punya laws, you know, that was given to them, the power for them to take action against those people. So good case for you to go through in order for you to understand nuisance. Eh? Nuisance is also a crime, eh? Whereby public nuisance, kalau kita tengok dalam apa ni, kita ambil ke bawah ni 268 ya, Penal Code ya, section 268. Kalau you go through Penal Code, then you will see it's a crime. Kalau kita ambil other laws like I mentioned already, Environmental Act is also a crime. Though environmental law ni yang menyampah sikit, nobody, air ini is going to be a problem, something is wrong with the agencies that made responsible for apa to monitor the water. The environmental ministry is not doing their job. Why? Maybe I can accuse. What else? You know, number one, you memang tak ada manpower. Okay, not enough manpower. Second is your manpower that you have is not knowledgeable. Third is your manpower that you have is corrupted. Therefore, you don't take action. If you have taken action against that people under your empowerment, so why it is keep on repeating? Meaning the laws or the enforcement is not harsh enough. Meaning the duty of the courts, yeah, is lacking. Yeah, so the contributory negligence of the courts to punish people. So the court is actually representing the society. So the court, if you are ending up as a judge, you are not settling the case in front of you. You are settling the problem that is coming to your courts. The type of courts, takkan you nak biarkan aku boleh apa, aku handle case ni, case ni yang depan aku, aku yang nak kena bagi decision, solution to that. You are not stopping, yeah, because the same case or several cases, the same goes to your friends, fellow judges. So you have to remember the number of influx of cases is going to burden the whole system, you know, because you do not play a role, because your case is earlier, so you must be able to prevent that from happening. So dah jauh kita menyimpang, sorry. So coming back, it is a crime, so action has to be taken on that matter. Person who may claim, number one is EG lah, yeah. So here I put EG. Nama Zida ni, my PC ni, though it is mine, tapi Zida yang keluar. Jangan duk apa defame, I kata, oh semua notes ni, what if they yang prepare.
No worries.
Okay. So kita kena caveat dulu. Kadang-kadang kita tak pergi caveat ni, susah orang interpret. Okay, B, civil proceeding where people who suffer special and particular damage. The word is special. What do you mean by special? Here, I letak kat situ. Special damages is in the form that damages that is suffered is above the ordinary inconvenience suffered by anyone else. So anything that is above the ordinary people punya suffering, katalah you duduk in the position di mana orang duduk dekat sebelah kilang, should be able to suffer some kind of smell, yeah, especially smell macam I dekat belakang ni dekat kubur Shah Alam ni, dia ada tempat simpan simpan sampah, kan, di depo sampah Selangor dah pindah ke belakang ni. So from time to time akan bau gila-gila lah. So it is must be above that position sampai smell tu boleh suffocate you. That is a special damage. Kalau bau irritating apa semua, I know that you have to suffer lah. You know, activity of that nature of apa orang kata simpan sampah kat situ, it is for the benefit of the society. You pun buang sampah, jadi sampah you akan pergi situ, you know. Dan sampah di locate dekat situ pun nak cari tempat yang very near to your place that is able for them to dump. Kalau lah kata sampah tu nak bawa ke rawang ataupun places that is lombong-lombong kat situ untuk nak buang, the cost of transportation is going to be high and therefore you punya cukai pintu akan naik. So dia ada interrelation tau benda ni. So there are certain things happening in our society that we have to accept. But sampai to the extent that you muntah, no, cirit-birit, that is what we call special or particular damage.
Sekejap, sir. Dekat you punya buku tu lain lah dengan kita orang punya buku ni, sebab tadi criminal proceeding, A, criminal proceeding, B, civil proceeding, right? Dekat situ you punya person who suffers special or particular damage, tapi kat saya punya buku ni is like B, civil proceeding, no special damage suffered by any particular individual. So, siapa ada buku macam I ni yang Nurcahaya juga, I don't know whether it's a wrong one or whether...
Yours is the latest one. Maybe because of the changes in the law that takes...
Sebab you place kat sini, Section 8.1 of the Government Proceeding Act 1956 provides that Attorney General or two or more person who have obtained written permission from the AG. That one is those who can claim under civil proceeding.
Yes. Itu yang case yang atas tu. Ada mention about that. Nurcahaya mentioned about what you said just now, Jimmy. And it is in relation to this particular case lah. MPPP and Boy Siu. It went up to federal court, as I already mentioned. They have this protection of the law that they were to do. Otherwise, if we don't have the protection of the law, your individual law that you can rely on, so you have to bring the problem to EG, and EG is to take up the problem in order for them to sue on your behalf. Yeah, if you don't want to have EG, you have to provide special damages, otherwise the court will not entertain. Okay, so the court will never entertain something that is just based on hearsay or based on non-factual things. So what do you mean by factual? It is based on evidence in terms of the suffering that you suffer is more than what normal people should suffer. Okay, and tapi you might have something in your mind saying that kalau I ada special di yang buka ikon. Thank you. Kalau say for example you have some other issue, yeah, saying that macam mana situation of apa macam yang tadi I kata, you are special, you have a special skin, therefore your skin is easily suffering because of the activity of the defendant. So susah, eh? Yeah, that one is a bit susah for you to prove. Yeah, Jamie, sorry, because sometimes there are differences, but I think generally they are the same, yeah?
Mine is the same as yours.
Oh, okay, right. So, what you mean by special, it is based on damages must be serious, yeah? Something that is serious in nature, therefore, you can prove it in court, then you might have a good chance of taking action. The damage must be a direct consequence, yeah, direct consequence, there must be a nexus or relationship when it comes to in terms of the relationship of the consequence of the act. Right. Next is Pacific Engineering. Pacific Engineering and Haji Ahmad Rais yang tadi itulah yang padi khasnya hampas padi ya. So that is situation. Dekat UK, kalau kita kat sini, dia kata proceeding may only be instituted by consent of AG. Why AG? Because AG is the representation of the society and therefore macamlah criminal law. When it comes to criminal law or defamation, no. Kalau nak ambil penal code, any criminal punya action must be supported by AG. Okay. So, yang ni lah Jamie kata Section 8.1 Government Proceeding Act. So, if you have that, then you should be able to utilize that. Ni dalam kes yang tadi itulah, MPPP dengan BUI tu. So, civil proceeding where there is no special damages suffered, macam mana? Okay, kalau lah kata there is no Section 8.1 of the Government Proceeding Act provide that Attorney General or two or more have obtained the permission from AG. So AG sendiri on their action alone or two or more person who obtain the permission may institute a public nuisance. They can do that. So we have a case of Koperasi Pasaraya Malaysia that in a related action, relationship in terms of the public nuisance, whether it is exists or not, consent must first be obtained from Attorney General. Okay, so in this case, the case failed to get consent. Okay, tapi that is the situation. So BUI again came up to reiterate that the Local Government Act 1976 are the one that they use in order for them to justify their action. Okay, they did not use the Attorney General. If they in purview of the action not taking by virtue of Attorney General, dah salah. Yeah, dah memang on technicality, dah memang dah salah. How can you start with public nuisance without the involvement of or permission of AG? Okay, AG yang sepatutnya ambil action or AG yang patutnya kena bagi you permission. Okay, habis on public nuisance, we are moving now to private nuisance. Any questions so far? I think clear. Siapa nak tanya soalan? Tak ada. Okay, private nuisance kalau kita tengok ni is the rights of a person over their land, yeah, in terms of the enjoyment of their land. So I punya tanah, I punya unit, I ada hak untuk enjoy my my domain ataupun my land that I have. Nampak eh? If you are looking at the private, you yourself in your land, you have every rights to enjoy your land. So, but nobody else is to interfere with your enjoyment in terms of how you want to have a peace of mind. Yeah, you want to enjoy tidur malam, and then suddenly orang pasang apa lagu sampai pukul 2-3 pagi. That is considered as. Kalau berkelahi macam mana? Husband and wife berkelahi pukul 3 pagi.
Bisa saja.
Berkelahi
lepas mengganggu
orang,
nuisance juga sih. It must be proven in terms of the time, ya, yeah, duration. Kalau lah kata berlaku selalu, you know, asyik pukul 2 malam berkelahi, you know. That is a good case for you to bring to court and say that that is private nuisance. Okay, So kita nak tengok apa requirement ya, the test. That yang penting sekali for us to understand the test that is going to be implemented by the court to determine whether private nuisance is to be given or not. So number one is that the interference is unreasonable, and then the second is the right of the plaintiff to enjoy his or her land. So that is the two requirement: unreasonable interference and the right to enjoy of the apa the space ataupun the land. So here kalau MPP here is the salah ya, MPP dia tak patutnya ambil private nuisance ya. Yeah. So kalau dia ambil private nuisance based on the local authority punya laws, then okay, right? Tapi kalau dia ambil on private nuisance just because they are considered as private, then the footing is wrong, because what you need to do is to show some kind of evidence in terms of damages. Yeah, you must prove, plaintiffs must prove interference with the enjoyment. Proof meaning you must have evidence. Evidence in what way? Evidence in terms of the, what do you call it, the reasonableness of the interference. Number one is that if you can prove that you suffered damages, even better, right? Establish how to establish does not need for you to prove special damages. Yeah, as long as you are able to prove that any reasonable person yang dalam keadaan saya, if you put any person that is in my position, akan suffer that kind of nuisance, and then it is considered as substantial. Okay. So you must prove special or particular damage. Kalau lah kata, does not require for the plaintiff to prove special or particular damage. Tapi dalam public nuisance tadi, kena prove that. Eh? So here, when it comes to this, what you need to do is to prove that you cannot enjoy your land anymore. And on top of that, there might be some kind of damages that you suffered. Damages in a way that it is normal, not able for you to enjoy the land anymore. For example, pukul 2 pagi, asyik orang. Saya pernah ada kat atas, unit kat atas, dia pasang alarm. Okay. Pasang alarm, dan alarm dia continuously bunyi. Pukul 6 sampai pukul 9 sampai pukul 10. You know, asyik bunyi, gering, 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 gering. Irritating, ya. Yeah? So, dah sebulan lah. Nothing is taken. So, I have to take laws into my own hands, and then I go to the unit, kata, hush sikit lah. You all ni ada otak ke tak ada otak? You know? You tak tahu ke you punya alarm tu duk ganggu? You know? You can enjoy your alarm. You might not pushing it off. I don't mind, yeah, as long as benda tu tak kacau. Yeah, bila kita telinga sensitif, duk bunyi ti, dah duk stressful. So alhamdulillah, because of that, the thing stop. So kalau jadi balik, you have to do certain things lah. But if you don't want to see them because they akan retaliate and very difficult for them to respond, then you have to go to the court. And going to the court, you know very well, involve money, involve time, involve susah lah. Yeah, I have already sue the bank before. I went into legal case with Maybank. Very technical, you know. My lawyer did not defend as what we expect. Yeah, so I kena buat pula argument. Then I have to defend myself. So bila kalah High Court, nak pergi ke Court of Appeal, you need another 20,000. So quite a lot of money that is going to be spent. Okay, so the interference, kalau is about the inability for you to use and in comfort of the land. Yeah? Whether that is unable for you to enjoy your land. Dia kata kat sini, amenity nuisance is the comfort, yeah, that you have over your land. feeling of discomfort whereby it is unable to live peacefully. You cannot live peacefully to enjoy your own land. So you can prove that because this is by virtue of substantial interference. Okay, how do you prove that? Then kita tengok case lah. There is no formula, obviously, to consider what is substantial interference, but it is case to case basis. So let's look at the case then. Wun Tan Kan, Wun Tan Kan, sian mati. Then the Asian Rare Earth, ni dekat Bukit Merah. I think Bukit Merah punya, jom kita tengok. Okay, pollution, radioactive pollution 1982. Ni ada yang tak ada lagi. So you can read this. Kalau you tengok ni, sedih ya, because the government is apa? Yang pelik ya. So the shareholders, Tabung Haji pun involved dalam case tu. Yeah, those people who suffered tak aci ya. If you look at the images, these guys, okay, look at this. Tengok, the sisa radioaktif is being not treated properly, and then they suffered leukemia, you know. Yeah, then ni, kami ulang-alik jauh 12 batu setiap hari tu mahkamah in Ipoh tu rujuk betapa seriusnya. This problem went up, and then they even some of their representative kalau you baca, went to Japan to talk about Masushita, if I'm not mistaken, Masushita. Okay, to talk about this problem. And kesianlah, I mean, these are the things that happen to society which is unfair. Mula diorang ambil sahabat alam to check, the government biasalah kata tak ada apa-apa, normal. They all discovered that 80%, 88% the risk of them to suffer some kind of damages. And then on top of that, they all panggil tak puas hati lagi. They get people from US, you know, to come over and do analysis. It is 800 times. Yeah. So, but funny, if you look at this particular case, they won. Yeah. They won the case in court. Biasalah orang miskin lawan dengan orang kaya. They can bombard you with all the technicalities, you know, things like that. So the court is not in favor of those people who are suffering, because the benefit that it can bring to the nation as compared is policy issue lah. Okay? Jadi salah. So eventually it was stopped because Mitsubishi, Mitsubishi or Masuchita, Mitsubishi stock. I think siapa Saya bagi facts yang lain lah. Okay. Mitsubishi, Mitsubishi Chemical. So Mitsubishi Chemical, finally they, okay lah, dia kata tak payahlah, we remove from the activity. Even though they have every rights to do continue with the action, because orang Jepun ni they're very apa aware in terms of people punya their problem. Okay, inti here kalau kita tengok ke Datuk Harman Harnam Harnam Singh. So they were at the clinic below the floor di mana dia ada operating renal clinic. So they suffered some kind of damages, and so they can prove to the court that they suffered damages. So it is considered above and over and above that is normally can be withstand by people. Okay, I think my kita pindah sat kot. My wife tengah nak masak. Jadi ganggu tak? Dia dengar benda-benda pelik tak? Guys?
Tak.
Bila benda-benda kacau tu dia fokus dia dah lari. Right. Material or physical damage, yeah. Kalau this is something that is not automatic lah, it's already stated here. But kalau ada actual, then it's okay. Yeah. Here it is, but the court is saying whether it is something that is able for you to prove or not. Kalau kita ambil case here. Go chat ni, okay, the defendant who was mining license carried on the mining work on his land. Plaintiff or whose land was adjacent to the defendant's land alleged that through their mining activities, the defendant had committed negligence and nuisance, where the mining activities constitute unnatural use of the land, and because of that, water that has escaped flooded the plaintiff's land, causing it to collapse and sink. So ni kita boleh nampak Ryland and Fletcher punya situation, kita boleh nampak juga nuisance, you know, in this case it is considered as nuisance, eh, because that is the one that they submit lah, dia submit for claim, right? So they are using nuisance, it is considered as acceptable. Here, what is the most important thing is that substantial interference with the enjoyment of the land. Yeah, so the same thing with the just now, eh? Material or physical, it is good for you to prove in order for you to win your case, as it is a proof that you are not able to enjoy your land. Because di sini, the main thing that you are going to, the first one that the court will look at is the substantial interference. So what do you mean by interference? It must be something that is unreasonable, and obviously it is substantial as compared to normal things that anyone would suffer. Eh, kalau bising construction, normal, right? Normal for people. It is interference, tapi it is considered as normal. Tapi kalau construction dekat apartment sampai pukul 9 malam, that is considered as substantial. Kalau lah kata benda tu nak kena repair juga pukul 12 malam, because if you don't do that, something that is drastic that is going to happen, for example electrical failure and things like that, then it is considered as justified. Okay, so far ada problem? Ada issue? Screen dah share kan?
So I have a question.
Yes, good.
So is there any weightage measurement in order to identify ataupun define substantial?
No. A reasonable man is a good test.
Reasonable man is a good test.
Yeah. The only test.
It's the only test. To basically interpret the term substantial.
Yes. Substantial in terms of measurement kan, so itu yang letak damages, suffering of things that you suffer lah. Say for example you tak boleh suffocate, that you have to go to the clinic untuk dah dapat oksigen, so it is evidence. So even though that might be an excuse that people will use in order for them to get something from those people kan, dah manusia ni nak duit zaman COVID ni, try to find ways of making money by maybe someone company yang besar-besar, right? So if you were to prove that in court, saying that you have to go to the clinic, you have to get treatment, you know, compensation of the clinic cost akan di sponsor by those defendant lah. However, you have to get the information that that oxygen that you want to put to your body is caused by those by the interference. Macam mana you nak prove that? Itu doktor report lah. So you kena pergi ke hospital betul in order for you to get government punya hospital to verify that private tak boleh pakai kan. So yeah, as far as evidence is concerned, kalau dekat court memang susah lah. Yeah, kalau government better. So dia subjektif no. Ini yang masalah dia. Bila when it comes to nuisance, because dia tak boleh nak restrict by virtue of a certain formula. Kalau letak certain formula, then you are restricting the law. Because thought is dynamic kan. It can change from time to time, meaning esok dia berubah, lusa dia berubah, you know, by the judges punya decision. So there is no, I mean it's quite stupid lah kalau the court is to come up with, look, we have to stop all this and this is the only formula. I mean people will look towards you and I mean the only person that can do that is the parliament. Okay, so parliament should come up with the law. Court is to only solve problems, but at the same time they can influence in terms of their decision. Yeah, so kalau you duduk dekat federal court, then you are able to some do your contribution to the society. Because parliament ni dia tak mau buat, dia banyak nak sembang siapa yang nak siapa yang nak duduk memimpin, you know, they want
Okay, substantial and turning dia adalah acceptable kan?
Yes, not acceptable.
Okay, substantial tu something beyond something beyond accepted acceptable lah.
Yeah. Okay. Contoh, bagi contoh. I nak contoh from you.
Okay, let's say macam you kata tadi kan, due to that nuisance, then I suffered, I have to go to clinics.
Mm-hmm.
Will it be a case whereby if I go to the clinic and then katalah the amount of my treatment damages cost me about RM300. Tapi can court come and say that, oh, that is acceptable amount for a person to tolerate such a nuisance?
Oh, so now you can claim not only the amount of 300 damages that you suffered, right? It's a evidence in court. However, you akan minta injunction. Remember? You kena minta some kind of court order, right? Mm-hmm. So bila court order, walaupun dia civil in nature, right? So injunction is a court order, right? Mm-hmm. But if the person still continue, then it becomes a criminal law, a criminal act.
Condemn court.
So dalam case yang MPPP tadi, kalau you baca case, Bui tu dia ignore yang pelik je kalau you baca tu. Dia selamba je dia jalan bisnes. Dia ignore and then no criminal action ataupun, sorry, bukan Bui, rare earth tadi. Okay, rare earth Bukit Merah punya. Dia orang selamba je jalan. You know, the company refused to stop despite court order. I think this is something that is very odd. You know, just because Mahathir was saying that there's no problem. Aduh, dia orang sampai Musa Hitam pun ada waktu tu. You know, you baca ni, la ilaha illallah, apa sebenarnya ni? You know, Jangan. Dia orang walaupun bukan orang Melayu, janganlah Jangan. Orang Cina pun manusia juga.
Ya, betul.
Tak boleh ya? Kita tak boleh ya?
Okay, so.
Unreasonableness, what is mean unreasonable? Because of the standard. We look at the standard macam mana. How to know that? There is no clear cut definition what constitute as unreasonable. Tapi kita tengok juga case ya. To understand that. Hunter, plaintiff claim damages in respect of interference of the television reception. Ya. Selalu kalau you pergi dekat mall, so kalau you perasan tak dia station kan tinggi tu, I think mall kot, perasan tak bila sampai kat mall kan semua rumah-rumah kat situ, because dia duduk dalam lembah kan, macam mana lah yang di mana reception dia memang susah lah. So
bukan mall
kan, kalau you lalu tengok semua kan rumah-rumah dia punya lah ni pakai apa satellite tak apalah, dulu dia pakai. So reception was down for 2 years caused by defendant building, yeah, which is 250 meters high. So the court held that in absence of the easement, where mere presence of the neighboring building do not give a rise to actionable nuisance. But then, you have other ways in order for you to get your reception. Okay, the reception you boleh dapat cara-cara lain lah. You minta dia orang buat transmitter, you know. It is not the problem of the 250 meter punya building that is causing the problem. Maksudnya easement ni, you have other ways. That is not the only way. Okay, so court tak kata tak boleh lah. It's not fair lah. Yeah, for you to say that they are to compensate just because they erect that building. So that becomes the standard lah. Yeah, how dia nampak tak di sini banyak guna hukum akal ataupun the apa orang kata, you kena smart lah nanti ya, you as lawyers nanti if you want to remember, don't worry about being smart ya. When it comes to law of thought is dynamic, so you don't worry about the law. You paling-paling lose the case, but if you want to ensure winning, then you explore every argument. You guna common sense, guna logic, yeah, guna reasonable man test. So that will convince the judge to side on your case. Kalau location, when it comes to location, kita tengok St. Helens smelting, yeah, rubber estate. Okay, smoke from the defendant copper smelting factory caused damages to the tree. Kita 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30. Oh my god, ingat ke habis pukul 12:30? Sorry. 3 jam lah, 11:30 lah. Guys. Guys. Aduh.
Ya, yeah, ya.
Yeah. Balik. Okay. Since we are stopping this area, I think what we can do is for you to go through on your own. Ataupun if you want, I can continue make a record of the session and then you can ni lah, tengok lah. So kita stop tadi kat mana?
Civil proceeding
dekat A. I will try to make a video and then post it to YouTube and you can continue with that. Boleh ya?
Boleh sir.
Actually hari ni I nak buat sejam untuk nak buat apa? Nak apalah, next week lah.
Tutorial
tu. Sepatutnya kena ada tutorial. Macam mana nak jawab kan? Okay, next week kita first hour tolong remind I untuk kita do that. So, insyaAllah. So, thank you so much for coming guys. Sorry. Kita break 15 minit je. Alright, Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, ada satu request, sir.
Apa dia tu?
Boleh tak nanti towards the end of the lecture, towards the end of the syllabus,
yes,
kita punya lecture class, kalau aha, kita boleh ada satu session untuk defense boleh on
apa dia? Me?
Defense on defamation.
Oh, defense on defamation. Boleh, tak ada. Kita okay. Extra pun tak ada.
Okay. Alright.
Dengan syarat, bukan seorang kan datang.
Boleh.
If you can get at least 5 from yang number 5 orang at least kita berbaloi lah, saya nak spend time.
Boleh.
In that session you boleh come in and kita buat troubleshooting in terms of tak kira lah apa-apa nuisance ke, strict liability ke, defamation ke, you know.
Boleh.
Lah. So reserve one day, so you in your group, so you decide lah bila hari yang you nak. Kita buat macam hari tu, kita buat malam pun boleh kan?
Boleh.
For those yang tak dapat dah hadir tu, kita record then kita bagi dia benefit lah, bagi pahala. So thank you very much guys. You set the date and time eh?
Okay sir.
Right. Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
See you guys next week. Eh, ingat pukul 12:30. Astaghfirullah. Tak ada tanda-tanda nak stop. Guys, everyone, you have to leave the session. Otherwise, the recording tak nak stop.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Astaghfirullahaladzim. Ya, oh ya ke? Oh. I over zealous nak buat benda tu, I lupa.